Hey everybody, today I am going to be altering a paintbrush. I found mine at the dollar store. I found two different sizes there, and this one is one of the smaller size. The other one is just a tad bit bigger. When I wanted to create something, I knew that I wanted to alter a paintbrush, but I was really having a hard time figuring out placement and composition and what I wanted to add to the paintbrush. So I'm going to talk a little bit about kind of switching your mindset a little bit. So I have this bin full of all kinds of random things, and that's where I got all of these items from. And in that bin, I have these pieces of chipboard. I don't recall exactly where I got them, but they're square, almost like ATC size. And I was had all of these embellishments and metal pieces and things all across my floor in my craft room. And it got me thinking that maybe I'll do an ATC instead. So I started placing all of the items on this piece of chipboard, which I did off camera, but I'm just kind of going through the motion of what I did. It was a mess. I had pearls everywhere. I had beads, all sorts of different things all over my floor. It was a big, big mess. And then I decided to just kind of transfer all of that stuff onto the paintbrush. And I ended up loving it, and I thought this will work. So if you're struggling with a piece, an altered piece like a bottle or a canvas or anything, if you want to do a layout or a card or something like that, and you're struggling, maybe switch up your thinking a little bit, and instead of looking at it just as a card or just as a layout, maybe think of it as something else like I did. It worked tremendously, and I will be definitely be doing this in the future because it really helped me out, and maybe it might help you out too, because I know a lot of people, and I know a lot of you have tell me that you get kind of stumped and don't know what to do, what to use or where to place it, things like that. So just kind of think outside the box a little bit. If you want to alter a paintbrush, do the same thing as I did. Take a little piece of even cardstock, and just kind of place things on there and then see what happens from there. Anyways, I painted the paintbrush with some white gesso, and now I'm just painting all of these pieces, and I was kind of challenging myself. I wanted to use things that are in this bin. This bin is getting way too full, so I need to use it all up. So I did not want to use anything that was in a package. Even if the package was already open, I wanted to use only things in this bin. So that's what I did. And you could start your own bin. It's just basically a bin of just random stuff. I have, as you could see, canned tops in there. I have metal pieces. I have Prima resin pieces, computer parts, those types of things. And it's just a random bin that I like to have on hand when I do mixed media pieces like this. And after I painted all of those pieces two times, I am now adding some white crackle paste to the paintbrush. And I am using a palette knife this time just to kind of give it a little bit of a thick layer this time. I let that dry completely to get the cracks as best as they can be. You can speed it up a little bit with a heat tool, but it is suggested to let it dry on its own. And I felt the handle needed a little bit of something, so of course I go to my trusty string. This is like twine or that sort of thing. I get the roll on Amazon. I think it's like $5 or less than $5, I think. And after I wrap that, then I'm going to paint it with some white gesso. And I'm trying to do the back. I tend to forget about the back sometimes of certain types of projects that I do. But I'm trying to remember that there is a backside to this. I was planning on using some of this doily, but then once I started placing all of the other items on, I decided that I did not want that. So I have this little piece, I think it's like RAM or something. And then I'll place the Prima, I think it's Ingvild Bolm Vintage Treasures, Junkyard Treasures. I don't know, something along those lines. And I have quite a few of these. I can't remember what else was in the package, but I've used up all of the other embellishments that were in the package, and that's what's left. I have a ton of these like little water things. I don't know exactly what they're called, but I'm trying to use them up, and then I'm going to add all of the other pieces. And I'm using FabriTac today. I wish I probably, well, I probably should have used some hot glue, just because things were coming up once I started to paint them again, and I'm very impatient. I should have let it dry, actually, to be honest. But if you are impatient like me, then you can definitely use some hot glue to just secure the pieces onto all together, and then wait for the FabriTac to dry later on, and then it'll be pretty secure on your piece. All right, so I wanted to add just a little bit more texture, so I'm adding some more string to the bottom here. And I kind of tuck it underneath just so it's kind of peeking out a little bit. String is cheap and it definitely gives texture, and you can add it to almost anything. And then I'm going to add some white gesso to that on the bottom there. And I hope the little tip that I gave in the beginning of the video, I hope I was explaining it as best I could. And I hope that you guys understand what I'm trying to come across to say, that you just maybe have a different look at something rather than just exactly what what it is. So maybe that will hopefully. If you're in a creative slump or a rut, then maybe try looking at it in a different way. All right, so I added a little bit more gesso, and then I am adding some Lindy's. This is steampunk sepia, I believe, or yes, and it basically gets covered up anyways, so this first layer doesn't really matter, but if you want it to be a little bit more brown and blue, then you can use those colors. I ended up basically doing all blue. The second color is Tainted Love Teal from Lindy's. I have said this before, but I do have lots of colors that I've had for years, and I don't recall exactly which ones are not available anymore, so I apologize, but I know that they do have lots of different colors, so you could probably find something similar. And in the description box, I will definitely have them listed, if not a very similar color. I do end up using the Prima Dragonfly Blue, which is very similar to this color, so if you can't get your hands on the Lindy's color, then the Dragonfly Blue color is very similar as well. So you could see here, it's just a little bit darker, a little bit more saturated color. I don't recall if I've added water to the Lindy's spray. Maybe that's why it's just a little bit lighter color, but yeah, so I add the color, the Dragonfly Blue. And then what I did actually is I sprayed it, and then you could see that on the top of some of the embellishments there is not much color, and that's because it kind of just flowed right off. And I wanted that because it helps once I start highlighting all of the texture and all of the embellishments with gesso. It just helps a little bit. It helps it go a little bit faster. So I'm adding now Gossamer Gold, and I wanted a little bit more more brown tone. Again, it pretty much gets covered up, but it you could kind of see a little bit in the end. I always say this, every layer you add, it helps the end product and the project, you know, all the different layers, whether it's texture, color, that sort of thing. And I love these two colors together. They're very pretty together. I'm really liking the blue and the browns color palette. So you'll probably see more of this. I'll try to kind of change it up a bit. After that dried quite a bit, I did heat it with my heat tool. And then now I am just adding the highlights with the gesso. And what I do is I use my heat tool as I'm adding the gesso, and I do this constantly and almost on every project. Is what happens when I use the heat tool is that it makes the gesso a little bit tacky and it adheres a little bit better to the top of, you know, all of the embellishments and things like that. And the color, because it is water-based, it wants to seep up and mix together with that gesso. Because this is a heavy gesso to begin with, it doesn't react as much as like a thinner gesso would, but you definitely can tell the difference when you add the gesso while you're heating it. It just gets thicker and it just kind of lays on top. You do have to do a couple layers because the color does seep up into the gesso a little bit and mix together a little bit. But for the most part, if you heat it as you're adding it, it will save you a lot of time. All right, so as you could see here, I'm just adding the gesso and just wanting to highlight all of those textures. You can even do this with, say, like a white pearl paint or something with a little bit of shimmer if you would like. I like the matte look and the non-shimmer paint. That's my preference, but if you want a little bit of shimmer and shine to your project, then you could definitely do that. And then in the end, you can add a little bit of the Art Alchemy wax. It won't show up if you just as much like the, say, like the vintage silk or something like that, if you just put it on top of the color, but you can let it, let me see what I'm trying to say here. You can add the gesso first and then add vintage silk, and it'll just give a nice sheen, kind of shine to the project. And it looks really pretty, but for this project, I just wanted it to be the gesso. So as you could see, it's all coming together really nicely. And I love the dry brushed white look. And I just continue to do this. It's definitely a process and you just have to keep working at it until you're happy. I wish I would have waited until it dried, the glue dried on the embellishments, but I do love how it turned out. It was definitely something smaller that I, you know, like an altered piece that I wanted to do. I was wanting to do, to begin with, a canvas or something along those lines, but I thought that I just felt overwhelmed and I didn't want to feel overwhelmed. I want creating to be happy and something that I enjoy. I want to enjoy the process. So I thought on a smaller scale, and then once I was starting to get frustrated with trying to figure out the paintbrush, then that's when I kind of switched it up to like ATC or something along those lines. And then I thought I could just transfer this to the paintbrush, and then that's how I ended up with this. So when you're doing a project like this too, you could see that I'm turning it upside down. I think that's important just to make sure that you're getting in all of those nooks and crannies. And then, especially for me, because I don't tend to put my head all the way over my project when I'm doing videos, then I can't see kind of like the back and like the very top of the project very well. But that is going to complete the project. I did add a sentiment. It says, follow your heart. It is from the Tim Holtz Small Talk stickers. But that is going to complete the project. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe and hit that bell notification. Here's a couple more videos you might enjoy. Again, thank you so much for watching. Leave me a comment down below, and I will catch you guys later. Bye.